video to show how we have the differences between the older version of the 6030A auto-ranging Agilent power supply with the GPIB connections. There is a 6030, which is the unit that is you see here, which is 200 volts, 17 amps. There's a 6031, which is a 20 volt, 120 amps, and there's a 60 volt, 50 amps, which is a 6032. The next step is opening up the instrument. To save time, what I've done was I've already taken the covers off, the screws out of the covers, and the handles. So there are four screws on either side of the instrument, here and here, and here and here. And when you take those four screws off, the cover comes off, and then there's the inner cover. The inner cover has four screws that are already been removed on the top, and there's four screws on either side that have to be removed, and removing those screws now allows you to get the inner cover removed. And this information is also in the manual. Now that the top cover and the inner cover has been removed, you can see where the interface board and the GPIB board are located, and that is these two boards. To remove those two boards from the product, you simply take the two cables that go from the control board to the interface board, and you just remove those. They simply can be pulled right off. You remove the cable that goes to the control board, which is as I show you here, and you remove this cable to the front panel, and all your connections are complete. You also need to remove a screw from the side panel to make sure that you can get your boards out of the instrument. I must say that there's also a second cable that needs to be removed and a third bias cable that needs to be removed as well to get the two boards out of the instrument. Now that we've removed the two boards, the interface board and the PSI board, one is the A7 board, which is this one where the connection is for your computer, and the A8 board, which is the power supply interface board. The A8 board, which is tested assembly 06031-61006, which can be purchased through Agilent support, and the A7 board, which is the one that's shown here, is 06031-61003. The manual will help you decipher which one of the two boards are defective. After you've identified the defective board, replace one or both and reinstall the boards back into the product, and calibration and testing will be required.